And we are joined in studio. John Henson is going to be at Mickey's Joke House. Two shows tonight, two shows tomorrow night. And if you want to try and win some tickets, 410-252-2727, 410-252-2727. Call that number, leave a message, and they'll hook you up with tickets.
I'm bragging about my daughter. We were talking about kids in the break. I just showed John Henson a picture of my daughter.
Stunning, isn't she?
What in the world? You did not have anything to do with this.
No question. I've questioned the milkman, the mailman, everybody. That's you know.
That is remarkable, and I think some gene testing is in order.
She's
because
a model. It's
I showed her the picture. That's her Facebook profile. Yeah, she does some modeling. So
that is some modeling. Gosh.
Yeah, we got John Henson and...
If I were you, I'd build a cage.
Talk Soup, Food Network. We haven't even touched upon Wipeout. I mean, we can go on and on and on. Everybody is fascinated. Everybody's saying we got to ask about the big giant balls. I mean, it literally took the nation by storm.
That was a crazy thing, man. That show was... I don't think anybody expected that show to become what it did.
And how did we just love, you know, we're here in Baltimore. Just forgive us. We're stuck here on the East Coast.
I get it.
In this city. And we love when we have, you know, somebody like you that comes through here. And we're just fascinated by that world, the process. You walked us through the Talk Soup thing a little bit. And just give us, you know, a little insight, a little behind the scenes of the Wipeout.
Well, one thing that a lot of people may not have realized is I and John Anderson were almost never at the course. I don't know that Anderson was ever at the course.
Whoa, really?
Because he lived on he lives on the East Coast. He was doing ESPN Monday through Friday. He would come out on the weekend. We'd shoot the green screens, and then he'd go home. I went out to the course a couple of times for like stunts where I would throw stuff at people.
Right.
But man, it all took place in a green. Basically, 90% of my career has been standing in front of a green wall in a closet somewhere in Burbank. Right. You know.
So you just watched the monitor and just commented.
Yeah, it was.
I don't think I knew that.
No,
I feel horrifically naive at this point in time.
Like 90% of my job was the writing leading up to taping. So,
right.
You know, I was very involved in the writing. So, you know, running the writer's room and helping put the script together and grooming the script and all that stuff. So, and that's the other thing is like on Wipeout, it was because it was reality TV, there were comedy producers. There was no writers. And people would be like, do you improvise that show? And I'm like, yeah, we just seamlessly improvise 60 straight minutes of nonstop punchlines. We're just making it up every day. We're like, whoo, man, again, no space left over, no awkward pauses. Nobody stepped on each other.
Amazing.
Nailed it again.
Show. Oh, yeah.
We had an incredibly talented writing staff and assembled a team of guys that, no one in reality television had any business putting together a writing staff like that because these were guys that could easily, and some of them have, gone on to write for late night talk shows and comedy shows. And, you know, so we put together a staff of comedy writers, not just, you know, people who write reality TV.
And well, yeah, because that show, I mean, it doesn't work any other way, right? You have the course itself. The course is a character on the show.
Well, that was a big
the people
thing.
Are the characters, but if you take you guys away from that, it fails.
That was not the original version of the show. When I was hired, right, it was we had to fight to get comedy in
yeah,
the show.
Right.
Like these were words that were spoken to me. Like I'm not paraphrasing. These are exact quotes. People were like, dude, stop trying to upstage the course with the jokes.
Wow.
This show is not about you guys. It is the course is the star of the show.
Yeah.
If you, I want you, this is what they would say. First year on the show, see dog, say dog. If
they
Gary
said
is running up
you.
The steps, I want you to say, there is Gary running up the steps. Like, and I was like, guys,
there's no way you're doing that.
I was like, well, I don't, first of all, why did you hire me? That's not what I do. And B, like, first of all, and B, and B, I was like, stupid people and children would watch if we just put in a music bed and didn't talk at all. Why not, like, right, layer in some comedy to try to give another reason to watch the show? And we had to, there were like raised voice arguments to get one back and forth between me and John Anderson in per show. One time a show, I say something, he says something.
Wait, so there, John Henson, there were, are there, because I don't even remember, right, obviously, but were there episodes of this show that aired where there was just no comedy?
It was just like, there were puns, but it wasn't, there was no effort to make it funny. And like, you know, any pop culture references, anything that we tried to put in, they were like, no.
So how did it finally?
We were just strong merciless. We were merciless, pressing to fighting. And then what happened was in the first summer of the show, some of the reviews started mentioning the comedy, and it was like turning around the Queen Mary. Like, they were like, oh, all right, well, I guess we could let them do a little bit more of that. And then, like, the more attention the comedy got, by like third season, it was like jailbreak, and I was wearing wigs and doing characters and accents and stuff. And then by, like, you know, the seventh season of the show, we did. My wife had a 40th birthday party, and I encourage anybody listening to steal this theme. Her 40th birthday party was, come dressed as the celebrity you share your birthday with.
Ooh,
it was a great theme.
Yeah.
And I went as Yul Brynner.
Okay.
And I went full on King and I, Yul Brynner.
Right.
So I had a friend of mine who was a movie makeup artist come in and give me like a full on film quality bald cap. And I was so blown away by how realistic it looked that from the makeup chair in my house before my wife's party, I called the executive producer of Wipeout. Yeah. We were going into the seventh season. I was like, we have to do a bald cap show. And he goes, I don't understand. Why would you be bald? And I was like, what difference does it make?
Doesn't
I will think of a reason. Just shut up. I'm doing this.
We're
doing a bald cap show. We did a bald cap
Yay!
Show. It was like, you know, by the end of the show, that we were all over the place.
All right. It's John Henson. We'll let you get out of here. Thank you. This is amazing.
Thank you, guys. And come and see me at McGoobie's. Two shows tonight, two shows Saturday.
And what is the act? What can people expect?
It is do not come expecting the puns from Wipeout. You will be sadly mistaken and possibly get a little PTSD. Look, I didn't go back to stand up to not swear.
Okay.
So no, it is not a family friendly show. It's a more sort of biting adult take on you know, being a dad, being a husband, and it's probably a little closer to who I am as opposed to the big broad comedy you might
TV
have
guy.
Seen on Talk Super Wipeout. It's a lot of fun, though. If you're married, if you got kids, come on down and we'll commiserate about it.
There are lots of ways to listen to 98 Rock every day. 97.9 FM, streaming live on 98online.com. The 98 Rock smartphone app on iPhone and Android, and on your Amazon Alexa and Google Home. Make sure to follow us on Facebook at facebook.com/98online.